to order.
It's getting hot in here. So hot, so hot.
KBLA Talk 1580 is apparently the talk of the town. From the LA Times to our talk radio competitors.
Hey, there was a story in the LA Times about Tavis Smiley. Now he is back with his own radio station, KBLA, black owned and oriented towards the black audience. So, Mo, considering your knowledge of Tavis and his audience, what's your take on this?
Well, I think in a general industry sense, I think it's always good when there are more outlets, there are more talk radio, there's more voices and representation at that point. I think talk radio had been too homogenous for too long.
Real quickly, is it going to succeed, yes or no?
I think it's going to succeed.
You think?
There's a new sheriff in town.
We're KBLA Talk 1580, and we don't black down. Black down. Down.
You ready?
It's the queen of royal bands.
It's time for the Rob Report with Robin Ayers.
Highlighting people and things you should know about.
Robin's got you covered. Follow Robin at Robin Ayers. You're listening to the Rob Report on KBLA Talk 1580.
Robin's got a lot to talk about.
Welcome to the Raw Report on KBLA Talk 1580, where we bring you the latest in entertainment news and trending topics and interviews. I'm your host, Robin Ayers, and I'm here with you Monday through Friday, 6 p.m. to 7 p.m. Monday through Friday is always a jam. We're having so much fun, and it's energetic on your way home. Listen, if you are in LA right now, please be careful because that rain is no joke outside. I don't know what's going on with California. It's not looking good out there. So you make sure that you are careful if you are driving home right now. I'm excited about today's show. You know, you guys are always welcome to call. You can always call. Feel free. You can make that phone call at 1-800-920-1580 if you ever want to just join in on a conversation. Today's show obviously is great. If you've been watching our social media, we've got Coco, the Coco from SWV, and her amazingly talented son, Jay Michael, who are calling in today. Not in studio for those of you who wanted to see their faces. I'm sorry. But you can go and check them out on social media if you want to see their faces. They will be calling in, so I'm excited about that. So if you have any questions or anything that you'd like to chime in on, again, that number is 1-800-920-1580. Feel free to join us at YouTube. YouTube, stream us there. It's a vibe. I'm telling you, I can't describe it. You just got to feel it. Everyone who's come over and joined the chats or just watched on social media, it's a vibe. It's like a party in there. So that's always fun talking with you guys as well. So you can do that. You can also, while you are there on the internet, make sure you follow KBLA 1580 on all of our socials, Facebook and Twitter and Instagram, all the fun ones. Make sure that you are following us right now and that you are following me too at Robin Ayers. I would appreciate that. And I'm always appreciating if you just send me a little note and just say hello. Definitely do that. But if you do not feel like doing any of that, you can feel free to use the open mic feature that's on our app. It's pretty cool. All you do is just go to the app. At the very bottom, you will see open mic, and you can just leave a message for whomever it is that you want to leave a message for. Any of the talent that you hear and listen to on KBLA 1580, you can just chime in on whatever the conversation is, and you never know, your voice might be played over the air as well. So it's going to be a great one. Like I said, we are going to have Coco from SWV, Jay Michael, who are incredible. I have a little clip that I posted on social media just from recently. I think it was probably a week or two ago that I saw them on the red carpet, and I was asking about, you know, just the journey behind J. Michael coming up in this industry. And that little clip right there, it was probably a 30-second clip, if that, has gone, I'm not going to say viral quite yet, but you guys love J. Michael. I clearly understand that. He has the most amazing presence and truly got a gift from God. So we'll obviously speak with him and Coco as well. When we come forward, we're gonna see if we can get them on the phone. If you guys want to ask them questions, we're going to do all of that. Talk about the show, because I've been telling you guys about the show. It's on Bravo. It's called The Queens of R&B with the SWV and Escape. I'm telling you, you need to tap into that show. But we're going to talk about all of that and so much more when we come forward. You are listening to The Raw Report on KBLA. Talk 1580. Stay there.
You're inside The Raw Report with Robin Ayers on KBLA Talk 1580.
Need legal help? Attorney Jovan Blacknell is an aggressive trial attorney specializing in criminal defense and civil litigation. Look no further than the law office of Jovan Blacknell. From personal injury to criminal defense, Jovan Blacknell has the knowledge to protect your rights. The law office of Jovan Blacknell understands the stress and anxiety that come with legal issues. That's why the law office of Jovan Blacknell supports the right to a fair trial. For Los Angeles Councilmember Mark Ridley Thomas, are you facing a legal battle? Log on to fightforjustice.com. Don't go through it alone. Let the law office of Jovan Blacknell fight for your rights. Log on to fightforjustice.com. Let the law office of Jovan Blacknell take the worry and stress out of your case. Call 310-469-9117 today for a free consultation. That's 310-469-9117 or log on to fightforjustice.com. Law office of Jovan Blacknell, where experience and dedication make the difference.
California is a great place to live and work, but those aren't easy things to do for students also going to college. That's why the state created the Californians for All College Corps, a way for students to build skills and help others while earning up to $10,000 for school. Commit to serve your community and we'll help you pay for college. Spots will fill up fast, so learn more and apply today at www.cacollegecorps.com. That's www.cacollegecorps.com. California is a great place to live and work, but those aren't easy things to do for students also going to college. That's why the state created the Californians for All College Corps, a way for students to build skills and help others while earning up to $10,000 for school. Commit to serve your community and we'll help you pay for college. Spots will fill up fast, so learn more and apply today at www.cacollegecorps.com. That's www.cacollegecorps.com.
Cookie wants to be a professional wrestler.
I'm Cookie Serratos and I'm 11 years old.
She also wants to win all the medals. That's why Cookie and her family make every day count, squeezing out her best with Go-Go Squeeze.
Okay, Cookie, let's break for a Go-Go Squeeze.
Go-Go Squeeze Fruit on the Go pouches are a nutritious snack made from 100% fruit with no sugar added.
Go, Cookie!
Because when you nurture your kids, you squeeze out the best in them. Squeeze out the best with Go-Go Squeeze. Not a low-calorie food. Products range from 11 to 13 grams of sugar and 60 to 70 calories per serving.
Let's be real. Mopping is a hassle. You have to fill the bucket, pushing a wet, heavy mop around, then cleaning the mop when you're done so it doesn't grow bacteria. A hassle on top of a hassle. Try Swiffer Wet Jet. With Swiffer Wet Jet, you start with a fresh pad and cleaning solution every time. And when you're done, you just toss the pad. Swiffer Wet Jet. The faster, easier, cleaner way to clean your floors.
KBLA Talk 1580.
We've got a lot to talk about.
Tired of being locked out of job opportunities and shut down by systemic racism? KBLA stands with you in fighting for the rights of black workers, and we don't black down. The Los Angeles Black Workers Center is a dynamic alliance of workers, organized labor, community-based organizations, clergy, students, and scholars, working collectively to improve the position of the black working class. The LA Black Workers Center takes a comprehensive approach to addressing the black jobs crisis. Their programs promote access to quality jobs, racial equity in hiring and retention, discrimination-free job sites, and they prepare black workers for employment in high-wage, career-track jobs. The Black Workers Center supports workers who need help protecting their rights on the job. They give workers access to quality jobs and remove systemic barriers to employment. To sign up for free career readiness training, get involved in organizing around anti-discrimination, learn about union apprenticeship programs, or sign on to a trade registry, please visit www.LABlackWorkersCenter.org. That's LABlackWorkersCenter.org. Together, we can beat the black jobs crisis. This is a community call to action from KBLA Talk 1580.
Giving you your daily dose of entertainment and celebrity news.
You're inside the Robin Report.
With Robin Ayers on KBLA Talk 1580.
Woo! Ladies and gentlemen, over 30 million records sold, one of the best-selling girl groups or groups of all time, let's just say that, still selling out stadiums and arenas, performing all around the world. And now into reality television with this show called Bravo's, the Queens of R&B. Please help me welcome Coco Gamble, music artist from SWV, and her amazing son, who's a fashion model and extremely talented singer himself, Jay Michael. Welcome to the Raw Report.
Thank you.
Hey.
Hi.
Hi, Coco. And hey, Jay Michael. Okay, Jay Michael's coming in. The rain got to him. It was the rain.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm fantastic. Thank you so much, Jay Michael. I got to tell you, I've been playing your single. I've been playing it out. I'm really rocking to it. I'm really feeling it.
Thank you. Of course.
I appreciate you both for joining me today on the Rob Report. What I'm going to do is divvy up some questions, because I have a lot of questions here for both of you two. But Coco, okay. I'm going to start with you. This industry you've been in for majority of your life now, right? How does it feel, black, white, young, elderly, any nationality, any culture, how does it feel to this day that so many people around the world know the lyrics to your songs and it makes them feel, you know, a certain kind of way? How does that feel for you?
Oh, it feels amazing to know that so many people love your music, love what you do still to this day, 30 years later. Mm. It's amazing and it's a blessing.
Yeah. Does it surprise you at all anymore? Or is it just sort of normal, kind of like written into the fabric of your DNA?
No, I still get surprised by some things. Yeah, I still get surprised.
Yeah. So your group, SWV, which was one of my favorite groups when I was, you know, when we were all coming up, that was one of my favorite groups. Mm-hmm. And I'm sure I'm not alone in that. But since 92, you guys hit the scene and took over the world in the R&B charts and so much more. But is there, looking back over the journey of you, because you've had a solo career as well as with SWV, have you had any time to think like about some things that maybe you would have changed in your journey? Or are you one of those people who says, you know what, everything that I've done has amounted to where I am today, and let me just use the lessons to pass along to both of my children? How do you feel about that?
Maybe I would have communicated better, but you know, God has his own plans, you know, so what I would have done may not have been what God had in store for me. You know?
Yeah. So, Jay Michael, you know, your mom has been famous, obviously, your entire life. I can't imagine what that must feel like, but I'm sure you're used to it, right? But now there's this resurgence of fame. I guess I want to say fame. You've been famous your whole life, you know, she's been famous your whole life, but there's this resurgence with like TikTok and reality shows, social media, that whole thing. How does that feel now that she's sort of re-famous, or I don't know if that's the right word to use because she's been famous all along, but you understand what I'm saying. It's sort of this resurgence in this new era, and you're sort of included in that now, J. Michael. How does that feel for you?
It feels amazing. I love it.
Is it strange, though? Like, okay, all these, because, you know, Week, the song Week, obviously, huge, humongous, mega song, has it has done some phenomenal things on social media, on TikTok, people, you know, doing covers of the songs for years. Does it feel strange? Like, okay, now this new generation, your generation, they all know, you know, your mom's music. It's not like they're, you know, when I grew up, you know, we were always like, oh, that's old school music, right? They don't know nothing about this new school don't know nothing about that old school music. But your mom's music and SWV, their songs they're no longer old school. They're in this generation. So does that feel strange to you at all?
No, it doesn't feel strange. It's more admirable than anything.
Okay. And J. Michael, I saw this question and I thought it was a really good question to ask for you. Do you think that your mom and your grandmother taught you to sing, or do you think you were born to sing?
I mean, I've always harmonized with them and everything like that, but they didn't know to what extent I could sing. So I think it was kind of a talent I was born with.
Good answer.
Okay, yes. And, you know, you guys, I did come across several videos of you guys singing together, but You're Always on My Mind. Y'all took that song, and I'm telling you, it took me all the way back, and, you know, it just made me feel some kind of way. I don't know. What's your favorite song to sing together, or do you have one?
I don't think we have one. We're just always learning new songs, and then we'll try to sing them together.
Yeah.
Have you tried to get in
on
his song?
We don't have a favorite one.
Have you, Coco? Have you tried to get in on his song? Have you helped him with his music?
Oh yeah, I've done some backgrounds on one or two of the songs. We've done a duet for the new album. So yeah, I get in on his stuff. I prefer to be in the background though.
Okay, just with his music.
Yeah.
Okay. So where does music, where do you go from here, Coco? Because you've done so much. Is it still like, do you still have the intention of creating new music, putting new music out there, whether it be with the group or solo?
No, not really. It's not like a passion of mine anymore. If I do any new music, it'll be just because. Mm-hmm. But I'm moving more into acting now. I just signed with CGM Agency. Mm-hmm. So I'm looking into getting into, you know, acting, doing my thing on a different level.
I love that for you. And wherever you go, I'm sure the fans will follow if it's in acting or whatever it is that you choose to do.
I hope so.
It's happening, sis. It's happening, okay? So that's true.
Yeah.
Speaking of getting into other things other than in the music industry specifically, let's talk about your show a little bit, The Queens of R&B.
Okay.
On Bravo. On this last episode, actually, the both of you had a moment there where, J. Michael, you were telling your mom, listen, you initially had some interest in being a dentist. So you were in dentistry school and you had a break and you were saying that you did not want to go back. And I want to hear from both of you on this, but Coco, you strongly encouraged him to go back. Was that from a place of, I don't want you getting into this music business, or was that more, I just want you to have a backup plan?
That is more, I want a dentist in my family.
Okay.
And he is the dentist.
That is fair. That is fair. Okay. Yes.
And I've waited all these years to get my teeth done for him to say he doesn't want to do it now.
Okay. And J. Michael, have you changed your mind? Because I'm sure you guys, you filmed that a while ago. Have you changed your mind? Are you done with it? Or is it still like in the back of your mind? Like maybe I can do that as a backup plan.
I mean, at the point of my life I'm in now, mm-hmm. I wouldn't want to do it. But, I mean, you never know what the future holds. So.
Mm-hmm. You know,
as of right now, it's a hard pass.
It's a hard pass. Okay. Ooh, okay. Mama don't like that. So, you know, I'm at that place in my life where I look around at all of my friends and I'm like, who do I know from every industry? I want a lawyer friend. I want a, you know, a contractor friend. I want a dentist friend. So is that similar to why, you know, you're saying I want a dentist in my family? Is it so that you can look out, Coco, and be like, you know what? I have a wide array of different friends and even in my own family, right?
No. I just want him to go to school and be this dentist that we have planned. I've had this plan since he was like 6 years old.
Oh, okay. Okay.
You know, so for him to just, we get here, we're like almost there, and you change your mind. It's like, oh, okay.
Mm-hmm. No, I definitely understand that. And how is it now, though? Now that, I mean, you are such a supportive mom. Clearly, J. Michael, and you could talk about this. You are comfortable enough to come out with your whole family. Your mom has been supportive of you in that. Now she's supportive of you in music. So now that you have arrived here, and obviously you're going to move forward, are you just, is it all hands on deck? Like, okay, we're all in this, and I'm just going to use whatever I can do, whatever resource, whatever advice to help J. Michael move into this new field of music with him?
Yeah, you know, I tell him I'm his mother. He can use me up. I don't allow other people to use me up. But he can use me up. Mm, so mm-hmm. I'll be his stepping stone. I'll crawl so he can walk, and that's how I look at everything. Mm. So whatever he needs me to do, I'm going to support him regardless.
I love that.
He wants to sing, so I'm here. I'm going to support him. But I'm still tapping that shoulder about being a dentist.
Okay, that's not going to go away quite yet. I feel you. J. Michael, I put out, you know, we saw each other recently on the red carpet, and you were just talking about how, you know, your mom supports you in just your life and just your career and everything. And when I tell you, people love you. People have been so receptive to just allowing you to come into, you know, a part of their life in a sense, if that makes any sense. How do you feel? You are grown now. You're 20 years old. Happy belated birthday. So now that you are... He ain't grown yet. Okay, he ain't grown. She's like, hold on. So, but now that you are here and you are making a name for yourself, talk to me a little bit about some of the things that you may encounter. Like, I can only imagine, and Coco, I'm sure you can speak to this as well, but I can only imagine some of the things that you have encountered in terms of the people and how, you know, the industry is, and maybe opportunists or people who are leeches trying to, you know, hold on to you, befriend you, that type of thing. How do you handle this new sort of newfound fame for yourself?
I mean, it's nothing I can do but to handle it. I mean, when it comes to differentiating, like, the whole friend situation, that's pretty easy. I've been dealing with that for years upon years now. Mm-hmm. But what people have to say online, I mean, it's online. They're mm-hmm. saying online, not going to say it to you in person, so it don't matter. Mm-hmm. I mean, you know, a lot of the negative sides that come along with, you know, gaining traction on social media or just in general, you know, I try to tune it out. Positive vibes only.
Positive vibes only. I know that's right. Let me ask y'all a question. Going back to the show. First of all, congratulations still being in this game. I know you guys are doing that next to Escape. But why? What are we doing with this drama? How come we can't just... It almost feels, Coco, it almost feels like... it's not contrived. I think that it's real. I think that there are some things that are actually happening. But you know how people have said, I'm sure you've heard it a million times, that girl groups can't get along, or, you know, women in general just can't get along. Do you buy into that at all?
I'm buying into it now. You know, SWV came into this on the humble.
Yes. Okay.
We felt like the guys do it all the time. Look at New Edition. They had Jodeci.
Yeah.
Now they got a guy. He sweat. You know, I'm like, girls don't ever seem to do that. So let's go here and do this. Mm-hmm. You know, and that's the way it was presented to us as a co-headlining situation. Then we get there, and it's like, oh, no, we want a headline. It's like, huh? Mm-hmm. I could have stayed home.
Which is exactly how it seemed. It came off like that on the show. You're like, listen, I could have. I didn't have time for any of this. Do you guys, first of all, do you watch the show back yourself? Do you watch every episode?
I do watch every episode because, you know, I don't know how it was edited. So I like to see, you know, I don't know what happened or what they're showing or what made the show. Mm-hmm. So made the cut, rather.
Okay.
So I watch it to see, you know, I'm entertained like everybody else.
Yeah, exactly. I'm definitely entertained. J. Michael, are you watching the show back too?
I am.
Do you find, was it drama filled? And please check me if I'm wrong on this. I could be wrong. Okay. I could be all the way left. Okay, there was a scene where Taj had gotten home. She was with her husband and her son, and they're sitting there, and she's like, oh, I got to get back out on the road. She was talking about Escape, and she was saying, you know, do you know who Escape is? And he was like, no, I don't know who Escape was. Genuinely, I mean, I'm wondering, okay, I can't speak for Taj and her family, but for you, Coco, did you put J. Michael on, and your kids, both of your kids, little Tracy and J. Michael, did you put them on to the old school music? I mean, it's not even old school. I don't even consider it old school. But did you put them on to Escape and along with your own music of SWV?
No, I didn't put them on to Escape. I put them on to, like, New Edition.
Okay.
You know, if you know me, you know, I'm a New Edition girl. I'm a candy girl for life.
Yes, yes.
So they know New Edition. They know BBD. They know Bobby Brown. My oldest thing, he don't know hardly anybody because he's not into that.
Okay.
But I guess J. Michael, he learned about Escape once he started doing the show.
That recent, doing
and,
this show.
Well, he knew of Candy from Housewives.
Mm-hmm.
But the group, he didn't know.
Okay. So, I mean, I guess I can see that if you have certain favorites, if you put out, you know, your own music, but then you also played around the house, maybe your favorite artists and your groups. I could understand that. Okay. So no shade there. There's no shade in your children not knowing certain. Okay. Okay. All right. And I'm glad you checked me on that because I was like, you know, how is it possible? But okay, let me fall back. Listen, I do want to get into more of the show. We come forward, we are going to discuss, there are several things that are going on and I need to figure out, and I want to let you both have it. I want to let you take the floor and just maybe clear some things up in terms of what's happening on social media regarding the show. But we're going to do that after new sports and traffic. You are listening to The Raw Report with special guests Coco and J. Michael. When we come forward, we will get to the rest of it all. Stay right there.
Yo, what's going on? It's your boy Eric Bellinger hanging out right here with my family at The Raw Report. Keep it locked.
More of The Raw Report with Robin Ayers when we come forward.
I'm Doug Davis, and here's the latest from the Black Information Network. House Speaker Kevin McCarthy is downplaying the legal case related to a hush money payment by former President Trump to an adult film actress. While speaking from the House Republican retreat in Orlando, Florida today, McCarthy said the Manhattan District Attorney's case is just political. He argued the payment involved personal money, and he shouldn't be able to be prosecuted under the statute of limitations. One of the former Memphis, Tennessee police officers charged with the murder of Tyree Nichols will no longer be in law enforcement in the state of Tennessee. Desmond Mills surrendered his license to practice. The 46th annual Atlanta Jazz Festival is announcing its lineup for 2023. It includes the Jazz at Lincoln Center Orchestra with trumpeter Wynton Marsalis, Latin jazz saxophonist David Sanchez, and bassist Stanley Clark. The festival will be held at Piedmont Park the weekend of May 27th. And that is the latest. I'm Doug Davis from the Black Information Network and BINnews.com.
In Lakeview Terrace on the 210 westbound of Wheatland Avenue, got a brand new crash making its way to the right shoulder. You're going to be hitting those brakes from Berkshire Avenue. Also in Irvine, 261 southbound of Jamboree Road, got that crash in the center lane. Laguna Beach, 73 northbound after the 133, that crash is in the center lane as well. And in Anaheim Hills, this is on the 91 westbound after Lakeview Avenue, that crash block in the left lane in the fast track lanes.
Hi, I'm Kyle at Blindster.com. At Blindster, we offer over 50 different custom window treatments, including faux wood blinds and shutters, all at prices less than retail. Plus, we'll send you free samples before you buy. Don't hire an expensive pro. Do it yourself and save big at Blindster.com.
Is this the title?
This is the KBLA Sports Minute with Ray Richardson.
Another important game for the Clippers tonight. They're at home against Oklahoma City. The Clippers trail Phoenix by a half game for fourth place in the Western Conference. The ownership group that Magic Johnson joined to pursue the NFL Washington Commanders is headed up by billionaire Josh Harris, founder of Yahoo Incorporated. Harris also owns the Philadelphia 76ers and New Jersey Devils. Magic and Harris will find out at the NFL owners meeting in May if their purchase attempt is approved. The Commanders are on the block for $5.6 billion. No debates, no speculation, just the info you need. That's your KBLA Sports Minute. I'm Ray Richardson. This sports report was brought to you by Original Taco Peace.
Aaron from Original Taco Pete's here, inviting you to our newest location at 3272 West Slauson off Crenshaw for Taco Tuesday, only $1.75. Call 323-348-4441 to order.
Hi, I'm civil rights attorney Areva Martin, host of Areva Martin in Real Time, weekdays 4 to 6 p.m. right here on KBLA Talk 1580. Be sure to tune in weekdays at 4:35 p.m. for your daily download on the federal bribery trial of L.A. City Council member Mark Ridley Thomas. The case is sure to have many twists and turns, and our program will be the show of record in the case of United States versus Mark Ridley Thomas. We have our own season justice correspondent who will be checking in with us to keep you up to speed on the daily details of this high-profile legal case. Be sure to tune into Areva Martin in Real Time weekdays at 4:35 p.m. for United States versus Mark Ridley Thomas, only on KBLA Talk 1580.
Order in the court.
KBLA Talk 1580. We've got a whole lot to talk about.
Aisha Cairo here, KBLA, live at Chase Bank on Crenshaw and Vernon for the In This Together tour with female business owners, a day of empowerment, community panels, and best of all, tips on building business from marketing to capital. Today, I was able to speak with Ola Wadibia, VP of Women on the Move. Hi, Ola. Tell me a bit about this initiative by JPMorgan Chase, founded in 2013.
Women on the Move is a center of excellence at JPMorgan Chase in our global DEI organization, where we really focus on diversity, equity, and inclusion. What's really awesome about Chase's approach is that all of our centers of excellence, and there are seven of them, focus on different demographic groups, is that we're really focusing on what's happening internally in the firm and also what's happening out in community. So really, Women on the Move is really focused on thinking about how do we help advance women professionally and personally.
I love it. So tell me about this beautifully updated banking branch here on Crenshaw.
That was really important. A part of our racial equity commitment was to build in place for Chase. So being able to revamp this beautiful space, to be able to welcome community members, you know, today anyone, nonprofit, organization, school can actually do events in our community center that we're sitting in here for free. Yes, people come inside, like grab a coffee, use the Wi-Fi. It's free.
Yes, I'm Aisha Cairo in the community for KBLA with JPMorgan Chase.
This is KBLA Talk 1580. Talk radio that's music to your ears. We're unapologetically progressive. KBLA Talk 1580. Keeping you informed about what's really going on.
Who's got next?
And what not to miss in entertainment. You're listening to The Rob Report on KBLA Talk 1580.
Inside the Raw Report on KBLA Talk 1580. Oh my goodness, if you are just joining us, we have Coco from the SWV and her amazingly talented son, Jay Michael, on the line. Welcome back in, you two. Y'all, I was about to start singing over here, you know what I'm saying? I was about to give you a little something.
Uh-oh, go ahead.
One of these days, we gonna, you know, I'm gonna ask you to harmonize with me, you know.
Okay.
That's a dream.
Okay.
Girl, it's just a dream. It's just a dream. Don't. That's all it is. Oh, my goodness. That song feels so good. It kind of takes me back. But we are now forward. We are here in 2023, and we are dealing with all this social media tension and drama. And I know you like to keep out of it because I took what you said on the show. You were talking about friends, but you prefer realness, right? You've always, as long as I've known of you or known you, you've always come off very real to me. And so I don't think that you really get down with this social media thing, but what's, if they're calling you out, are you about it? Are you jumping in, or what is it that you want to clarify with this, this drama going on social media?
I don't do social media drama. I've seen everybody in person. So if there was a problem, we should have addressed it in person.
Okay. It's fair.
We're grown. I'm not playing these on social media games.
Yeah. No, I definitely get that. Jay Michael, when you're watching stuff like that, and to be honest with you, nobody's coming for you, Coco. Like, nobody's really coming for you. I think that I feel like, you know, your name, your voice, your talent, everything speaks for itself with all the ladies. Because somebody was just on social media saying something, and I had to chime in, and I was like, listen, hold up. Everybody is talented here. So I don't understand why, you know, one person wants to throw something out. Specifically, though, I'm about to go in. All right. I'm about to go in, and I'm a call it out. Tamar is, you know, she's got this ongoing feud with Candy from Escape. Okay, we'll set that to the side. But Candy starts, you know, coming out and talking about, you know, the stats of you know, her group. Okay, that's also fair. But when it starts to do, like, some, when it starts to get into the comparison thing, you know, Escape versus SWV, specifically what she's talking about is this headliner situation. That's the big question, because y'all just talked about that. This was this last episode. It was, who is going to headline this show? Now, let's be clear. I started off by giving y'all props. Y'all have been in the game and sold 30 million records. I mean, it is not even a joke. Y'all are still performing around the world. Everybody knows you, knows your songs. Everybody covers your songs. And then you have Escape, who we also love, who is also a great girl group, has not sold as many records and have not, they've not done sort of that same when it comes to the numbers and things. But what they do have is this this new reality TV thing when it comes to Candy and Tiny. So let me just play this small little clip, and I just want to get your feedback on it. Just whatever you say will stand, all right? We don't got to get too deep into it, but I want to play this little clip and just see what you say when it comes to Candy. Let's go.
WV is just about, we got to maintain the fees that we get. Another example, I don't want to speak on exactly what their fee is, but at the time, our fee was 3 to 4 times what their fee is. So why would we agree to split our fee and split in half? Then that means we are lowering what we get just so that they can say they felt comfortable.
Okay. So now that you have heard that, I'm sure you've seen it on social media. How do you feel about the headliner situation? I know you said that, listen, you thought from the jump start, that's what it was going to be, right? We were both going to headline. But when they started, you know, kind of fighting back and pushing back, what are your thoughts on that?
My thoughts were just like, we can go home. We wasn't stressing it then. We're not stressing it now. Mm-hmm. It was supposed to be a one-off. I don't know if you've ever seen a 112 and Jagged Edge show.
that they had put on where they would, like, one group would come out, then the other group would come out, and then they probably would come out and sing something together.
Mm-hmm.
It was supposed to be a collaborative effort.
Mm-hmm.
So why are you going to get paid more than us, but we're doing the same amount of work? That doesn't make sense.
Is that why this is so important to them? Because it is a one-off and it's not like a tour where, you know, maybe it can be, you know, you guys headline one time, they headline. You know, is that why it's so important, you feel, for them?
I have no idea.
Yeah.
We're just as surprised as everybody else. We don't know.
Okay.
Like I said, we've seen you guys. If there was a problem, we could have talked it out. I don't know.
Mm-hmm. So, obviously, you know, we still have the rest of however many episodes we have left of this show, and we will see where it goes from here. But is there anything you can tell us to describe where this leads without giving away, you know, too much? You said no?
Nope. You just got to keep watching.
We will keep watching. That's a definite.
Honestly, yeah. Don't remember everything. It's just like, when I'm watching the show, I'm learning things and remembering things with everybody else. So it's like, oh, yeah, okay, so... Yeah.
Okay, so it is. That's the problem with reality, they say. Like, you might go through something months and months and months ago when you were filming, and then it may be squashed. You guys may have come to a healthy resolution, and then all of a sudden the show airs again, and everybody's kind of back in their feelings, and, you know, everybody's chiming in from social media and stuff like that. So is that kind of what's happening too? Like, you're just in a peaceful place?
No.
Oh, you're not? Okay.
No. Where SWV is in a peaceful place with each other.
Okay. Because, you know,
we were when we started, we were when we were filming, and we are still today after filming.
Okay. Well, listen, your group mate.
But wait, I will say is Pasha and I are really close.
Yes. And as a matter of fact, when you two were, or when the group, when you two groups were getting ready to do your versus battle, I had a conversation. It was an IG live interview with Tasha where she gave y'all love, of course. She was even singing y'all song, Rain Down on Me. And she mentioned that you guys are very close. How do you feel about the heat that she's catching right now? Because it seems to be a little unfair. And I try to keep an open mind about it because, obviously reality is they're going to shoot it one way or edit it one way. And then we don't get to hear all sides of the situation, but you are a close friend of hers. So how do you feel about how she's being portrayed?
I hate that,
yeah.
You know, but I don't like to get involved in family business, and I tell her all the time, just make it right with your sister.
Yes.
That's it.
Yes.
You know what I mean? That's your blood sister, your biological sister, y'all have to make this right. But, you know, I rock with Tasha because I've been there before where people have banded together just for their dislike of me. So I know what she's going through. I know how it feels. So I definitely wasn't going to add to it.
Mm-hmm.
She needs support. I'm her support. And that's it.
Yeah.
And I just pray to her and her sister, they just come back together and they'll be able to love on each other. All that other stuff, it'll be there or maybe it won't, but that's their family, and that's what's important.
I love that you said that. Is there something you would tell people who are watching or people who have opinions about her one way or another, or you don't care about what they say? Where do you stand on it?
I really don't care what people say.
I love it.
You cannot live like by what people say, what they think. They're going to pick sides. They're going to have things to say. And half the time, they don't have no idea what they're talking about. So I can't get my pressure worked up over what these people that I don't know are thinking.
Okay, come on now. I mean, you're giving a master class right now on basically how to be unproblematic with social media. For real, for real, for real.
I'm
love
growing.
It. You're growing.
I am growing because there was a time where I would have been up there cursing the folks out, but for what? I'm not doing that.
Yes.
You know, my son is watching me. I have a set of 12-year-old twins in my house that are watching me that they think I'm so great. I don't have time for it. I'm not going to let y'all drive me crazy. I'm crazy enough.
I know that's right. And speaking of growing, you I'm sure you see all of this stuff, but Tamar, who also claims to be growing, she's a different person. She is throwing shade left and right. I mean, against all these people. My
I
gosh.
I love Tamar. I can't even fret. That's the homie. That's my girl.
Okay,
so,
yeah. Okay, so nothing to say there. I mean, because, and you're just trying not to get into the beef, even if people are bringing you up because they're going there. They're like, listen, you can say whatever you want about anybody else, but Coco, she's got the vocals, she's got the numbers to prove it. So you just stay out of it. And that's where you are.
I'm out of it for now.
Okay,
I don't know what's going to trigger me, but it doesn't make sense to me to be online arguing with people that I don't know.
That makes sense.
I don't know that. This TV thing is kind of different, and I'm just not going to do it right now. I don't feel led to.
Yeah, well, that's another thing. That's what I was asking Jay Michael. Like, you know, this is a resurgence of fame, so to speak. Not that you've never been less famous, but... it's new. It's a new sort of, thing for you, a new vehicle for fame. How are you handling that? Coco, are you
me
trying to,
Jay?
Yeah, are you,
well,
are you
for
trying?
Me, like, as long as you don't mess with my kids, I'm fine. You
okay.
Mess with my kids, you're going to see a different side of me, but other than that, I'm good.
Okay. speaking of being unproblematic, Jay Michael, you are probably the most chill, unproblematic person I've ever talked to. I mean, is that partly what you are getting from your mom? Is just to be like, listen, I don't want no problems. I want peace. And that's how I'm dealing with, you know, all of this stuff going on.
Yeah. I've had a troubling past few years just mentally. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, I'm at the point where I don't want to really argue with people. Mm. I have no problem setting anybody straight and giving you the business online. But at the end of the day, I really do try to be more positive, just work on myself more. So I try to stay away from all that.
I appreciate that both of you have opened up about mental challenges. I mean, obviously, you know that that's something that has been going. It's been it hasn't been trending. I don't want to make it sound like trendy, but more people have been opening up about it and being honest about it, because typically or historically in our past in the Black community, everything is taught to be like, you know, keep quiet, keep it on the hush, or pray about it. You know what I'm saying? Let's go to church.
Right.
And all of that. Mm-hmm. But how do you feel now that you have both opened up about mental health challenges, about therapy and seeking help? What have the two of you done, and what do you recommend anybody else to do for those who are having challenges?
You know, I used to be on that, you know, don't talk about it, pray about it, but I needed more, so I got help. Therapy has been great for me. Therapy has been great for Jay. Mm-hmm. Medication, it works for me. You know, I'm still fabulous. You know, yeah. I don't let nobody make me feel less than because I have a mental illness. Mm-hmm. I'm just not, and that's just me. I'm a strong person anyway, so I'm not going to let anybody make me feel less than. And if I can help somebody by telling my story, then I'm doing what I'm supposed to do.
That's a blessing. That's what we're here for. That's what we are literally on earth to do, is just take all of our challenges, our greatness, all of our life's lessons, and help pass them on to other people. So I appreciate
Absolutely.
That so much. We have a few more minutes, and I do want to get into this song. Oh, come on, Jay Michael. I told you I've been playing the song now. I've been bumping the song. You think I'm lying about it. But tell me, let us know, where did the inspiration for Never Be come, and what was the feeling behind getting into that? Actually, you know what we're going to do? We're going to, on the other side, we're going to play this song, and I want to hear your answer for that. We're going to play Never Be on the other side. You are listening to The Rob Report on KBLA Talk 1580. Stay there.
What's going on, y'all? It's your boy, Lil Real. How are you? Right now, you're listening to KBLA Talk 1580. That's right. The Rob Report.
You're inside The Rob Report with Robin Ayers on KBLA Talk 1580.
Women are taking up space in the political sphere, but Black women still have yet to really make their mark. This is Maisha Cairo with your K-Black Minute News, brought to
to you by Lendestry. Story courtesy of CaliforniaBlackMedia.org. On International Women's Day, the Public Policy Institute of California held the Women in California's Legislature Luncheon. Assemblymember Tina McKinner from Inglewood headed to Sacramento to sit on the panel. The woman-led panel discussed California's future and their essential roles in shaping governmental policies. This year's class of legislators held the largest number of women in state history. With 18 senators and 32 assembly members, and although black women are 8% of the 15% population of women in the country, they only fill 300 of the 7,000 state legislature seats across the U.S. McKenna made sure to emphasize the importance of this event and of women in color in politics, stating women bring diversity to the table due to the ways we take care of our families. I'm Aisha Cairo, and that's your K-Black Minute on KBLA Talk 1580.
Thanks to our new sponsor, Lendestry. Lendestry is a national black-led small business lender that is headquartered in Los Angeles. Lendestry helps small business owners access the affordable capital needed to grow. Visit Lendestry, LendistryKBLA today.
KBLA Talk 1580 celebrates Women's History Month, sponsored by Walmart. As we celebrate Women's History Month this month, KBLA Talk 1580 would like to spotlight women leaders in our community who are creating positive change. If you or someone you know is making a difference in your community, please nominate them with a 50-word or less post on why you feel they should be included in the KBLA Women's Series, sponsored by Walmart. These women leaders will be featured on KBLA, interviewed on KBLA, and participate in a panel discussion hosted by Ariva Martin in real time. Visit the KBLA app or log on to KBLA1580.com to nominate a woman in your community that is creating positive change. This has been a KBLA Talk 1580 community call to action.
Congratulations to Revolution Company for being this week's winner of KBLA's Office of the Week. Log on to KBLA1580.com to enter your office to win lunch for 10, delivered by John O'Groats Family Restaurant.
Giving you your daily dose of entertainment and celebrity news.
You're inside the Rob Report.
With Robin Ayers on KBLA Talk 1580.
Well, listen, you guys, I am just so happy and honored that you chose to come on to the Rob Report and spend some time with me today. Before we get into this song that I want you to introduce, J. Michael, let us know what more. I mean, Coco, she ain't giving us nothing from the show. Let's be clear. She ain't telling us nothing. She said you got to watch it. Outside of that, can we find you anywhere? Can we pick up anything or look forward to seeing both of you in anywhere?
Our YouTube channels.
Okay. Hey, now. Yes.
Yeah, we both do YouTube, we vlog and do all that fun stuff. So that's a different side that people get to see that you probably won't get from, you know, the TV show or just social media as a whole.
Okay.
And like I said, we both signed to this new agency, CGM Agency. So you should be seeing us on your TV screen soon.
I am so excited. I'm really happy about that, though, for both of you and J. Michael. I'm going to follow your fashion journey. I saw you walking at that runway. I was like, okay, give me some lessons, because the way you did that, you were stepping out. So that's nice. Awesome. Very awesome for you. But I'm also very excited for you to introduce this song as we say goodbye to Coco and J. Michael. Please let us know about this song and what was behind it, and I want you to introduce it as well.
Well, the song is called Never Be. My producer brought me the track, and it had, like, an instant connection to it. So special that I started writing the song almost instantly. Mm. I didn't really have any means to do so at the time. But the lyrics kind of just flew out of me. As I was listening to the song, I was typing down, kind of freestyling almost in a way. So, a lot of the lyrics in the song were sung first, like, straight out. Like, that's coming straight from my head. So the song has a very deep connection to me. Just pretty much explaining walking away from somebody who's kind of done you wrong so many times. Mm-hmm. I was in that kind of situation with somebody. And it came to a point where I just had to call it quits. You know, kind of just start loving them from a distance. So that's kind of how Never Be was birthed.
Ooh, okay. I thank you for that background on it. Introduce this song for us, and J. Michael has got next. Go ahead, J. Michael.
Yes, y'all. You're now listening to my new single, Never Be.
Woo!
Get this message, cause all you did to me, you won't see heaven. I gave you up my heart and you just went and tore it right apart. I don't know why you play me like you did. So pack it and make it quick. I never wanna see your face again. That's why
you could never be. Why can't you see all the things you've done to me?
You regret them, begging for a second chance. You need to get to stepping. You put me down and knocked off my crown. I still need to know, oh baby, why you play me like you did? So pack it and make it quick. I never want to see your face again.
Jay Michael, never be. Okay, I hear you with the background vocals. Come on, harmonizing and all of that stuff. He got it from his mom and his grandma. Listen, Coco, Jay Michael, I want to thank you both so much again for coming on to the Raw Report and blessing us. Again, what not to miss? You guys cannot miss Bravo's the queens of R&B with SWV and Escape. Please don't miss them on social media. I truly want to thank you both for coming on. Thank you for so much for
Thanks
spending your
for
time.
Having us.
Thank you.
Absolutely. So let me know when you're back in LA. We'll get together and we're gonna harmonize, Coco.
I sure will.
And Jay Michael, you're gonna give me that. You're gonna give me that walking lesson. All right, you two. Thank you so much. Have a great night.
Bye.
Bye bye. That is Jay Michael, Never Be. Jay Michael's Who's Got Next. Listen, that was our show with SWV's Coco and Jay Michael. I had such a great time. And I'm sorry I couldn't get to any of your comments, but I want to thank you for watching. Thank you for tuning in. As always, you have to stay right there because Zoe Williams is coming up, the voice of reason. Talk about your relationships. Talk about all of those beautiful, beautiful things. I am your host, Robin Ayers. Today and every day forward, be a blessing.
KBLA 1580 Santa Monica.
I'm Doug Davis, and here's the latest from the Black Information Network. President Biden is hosting some of the nation's top artists, designers, and musicians at the White House. Biden hosted an awards ceremony on Tuesday to present the 2021 National Human